Boker Tov, good morning everybody, Boker Tov, thank you for joining us for our Monday class. Baruch Hashem, we are here in Kolel Ahavat Israel in La Jolla, San Diego. Baruchim Abayim, we're very happy to have you here, all of you. We wanted to, Be'ezat Hashem, start this class first and foremost in honor of two very special people that needs refuah shelema today. We have Be'ezat Hashem refuah shelema leBaruch Chai ben Chaya Miriam ולBe'ezat Hashem Ephraim ben Devora וגם כן לרפואה שלמה של נועה בת אורטל, בנימין בן הדסה, יעקב בן גניה, קרן בת אליזה, אליעזר בן לאה ובעזרת השם גם כן שולמית בת ציפורה. אז בעזרת השם הקדוש ברוך הוא ישלח להם רפואה שלמה, אין נא רפן עליהם, אין נא רפן עליהם, אין נא רפן עליהם, ולהבדיל אלף אלפי הבדלות בעזרת השם לעילוי נשמת תלמה בת מרדכי.
אמן.
הגבאי שלנו יוסף הצדיק, his mother, may rest in peace בגן עדן נשמתה בעזרת השם. Alright, so today's class is about good versus evil. You know, we're coming upon Parashat Vayishlach. Vayishlach is the story of Yaakov coming back to his homeland, to Israel, and in the waiting is Esav, his brother that want to kill him. So it says, Vayishlach Yaakov malachim lefanav, אל עשיו אחיו ארצה שעיר שדה אדום. So first and foremost, יעקב אבינו now is 97 years old. And he is right now after 36 years absence from Israel, after 36 years that he was outside of the land of Israel, יעקב אבינו spent 14 years in the yeshiva of Shemen Ever. And after that he was 20 years with Lavan. And of course, 2 years of travel back and forth, 36 years. By the way, hence, when he married Leah first, Leah in Gematria is 36, alluding to the 36 that he will be missing. So Yaakov Avinu is coming now upon his brother Esav, and the Torah said that he sent angels. So the Zohar will teach us that Yaakov Avinu sent two groups of angels. There is, as we know, there is what we call the angels of mitzvot, right? It's called Malachi Hasharet. You know, every time we make a mitzvah, the mitzvah is basically allowing us to create an angel. So Yaakov Avinu had many mitzvot. And of course, we see that there is the angels of the land of Israel. We know in Yaakov, when in last parasha, Parashat Vayetze, Yaakov had the dream of the ladder, as we know, and he saw malachim olim veyordim, angel that goes up and down. And of course we see that Baruch Hashem, Yaakov Avinu had angels of the land of Israel, and now that he's outside of the land of Israel with Lavan, he has the angels of the diaspora. So Yaakov Avinu sends two group of angels. The Zohar says that Yaakov Avinu sent this group of angels, and the angel came, as we say, lefanav. The Zohar says, what's lefanav? Yaakov Avinu asked the angels first and foremost to see if hapanim shelo, lefanav is his face, is still illuminating on the, what we call, Maaseh HaMerkava, the chariot of Hashem, the throne of Hashem. As we know, it has four elements that carry the chariot. As we know in the book of Yechezkel, is Aryeh, Shor, Karuv, and Nesher and Yaakov, and the mankind. So we see that Yaakov sends those to Esav, and he sends, and the Zohar says that actually those angels came upon Esav and beat him up back and forth, and he keeps saying, please leave me alone, my grandfather is Abraham. Then he goes, my father is Yitzchak, and I'm a brother of Yaakov. Only then the angel stopped, and it says to him that Vayishlach. You know, Yaakov Avinu feared Esav a lot. As we know, Esav wanted to kill him. Esav said, that he will kill him when his father dies. When the angel goes out to what it says, Seir Sede Edom. Seir, as we know, is because of Esav was full of hair when he came out, and Edom is from Ha'adom Ha'adom Hazeh, as we said that Yaakov Avinu purchased the Bechorah, the first right, and Esav, of course, was reneging. You know, all of a sudden he had what we call seller's remorse. You know, seller's remorse, if somebody sells something and then he changes his mind, he says, ah, I didn't want to sell it. Even though he got paid, he promised, everything that Yaakov Avinu did was completely kosher, and of course Esav was even swore by it. So he says, ויצב אותם לאמור, כה תאמרו לאדוני עשיו, כה אמר עבדך יעקב עם לבן גרתי ואחר עד עתה. So we know here that Yaakov feared, and Hashem was very upset with him. Because you know, Hashem promised him, I will protect you whenever you'll be. You know, as we know, both in the dream that he had, and also in the promise that HaKadosh Baruch Hu gave him the blessing. And Yaakov now doesn't trust Hashem, and he sends angels to protect him, basically ask Esav to have mercy on him. We see something amazing here. You know, the Torah will tell us that Esav basically promised to kill Yaakov when he was without a father. And Yaakov feared now that his father is dead already. And Yaakov sends the angel. And the angels, and as we said, Yaakov did not trust Hashem, sends, you know, as if like he needs somebody else to, you know, protect him, even though Hashem promised him, I protect you. The word Vayishlach is Yaakov Chalash, you know, Yaakov was weak in his belief. And we see here that Yaakov, by the way, used the terms Ani Avdecha, you know, you are my master. The Zohar says it was 8 times against the 8 problems that in the future will happen, includes the Holocaust and everything from the people of Edom. And it says that Yaakov says, Im Lavan Garti. What's Im Lavan Garti? Im Lavan Garti means I lived with Lavan, but Garti is also Taryag Mitzvot, the 613 Mitzvot. Yaakov Avinu says, listen, I lived with the worst of the worst, Lavan, which is just like you. Maybe not as horrific as you as far as killing, but it was a cheat. Lavan is Naval, and I was able to win him without any problems, meaning with the Torah. Taryag 613 Mitzvot. The Torah says that Yaakov Avinu says, I have also Shor v'chamor tzon v'eved v'shivcha. Yaakov says to Esav, listen, I have Shor v'chamor, an ox and a donkey. And you know, Yaakov had a lot more than that. What Yaakov was hinting, I have shor and a donkey. It says, Mashiach ben David and Mashiach ben Yosef. The shor is an ox, which is resembles the bracha of Yosef, which was the ox shor. Shor is Mashiach ben Yosef. Vechamor is Mashiach ben David. The Mashiach ben David will come riding on a donkey. It's not literally a donkey, you know, just so we understand. It means that Mashiach ben David will be controlling all the material stuff in the world. Chomriyut, from the word chamor, means chomer, means the matter. That Mashiach ben David will be above all matters. And it says here that Yaakov Avinu says, I also have in my hand the Shivcha and the Eved. I have also Satan and his wife, Elit. As we know, it's Plonit Almonit. So the Zohar says that Esav sends to him those two angels first, the angel of the Satan and his wife. And Yaakov Avinu says, I have them all, I won them too, I beat all of them. And he says, Lagid la'adoni limtso chen be'enecha. I want you to know I'm doing this in order not to fight you. You know, the Zohar says that when Yaakov Avinu saw the angels coming back, Vayashuvu amalachim el Yaakov lemor, Banu el achicha el Esav, Vegam hu holech likratcha ve'arba meot ishimo. So you know, the angel that Yaakov sends, as we know, remember in the last end of Parasha, it says that Hashem send an angel, they're called Machanaim, the two angels. And because of Yaakov Avinu was learning Gemara all the time, the angel of Gemara, by the way, is the acronym of four angels. Gemara is Gavriel, Michael, Raphael, and Uriel. Our sages will teach us that HaKadosh Baruch Hu, a third of his time, is learning Gemara with those four angels. And wherever we learn Gemara, we merit those protection of these angels. Why? Because we have even the pasuk that says, Ki malachav yitzavelecha lishmorcha bechol derechecha. You know, Hashem sends angels, as we know. Yaakov Avinu wrote one of the many verses, actually, but one of the verses that Yaakov Avinu wrote in the book of Tehilim, you know, is Esailai Anari Ma'in Yavo Ezri, Ezri Meim Hashem Ose Shamayim Va'aretz. You know, this verse of Tehilim, it says, Ki malachav yitzavelecha lishmorcha bechol derechecha. Ki is kol yom. Kol yom HaKadosh Baruch Hu has the angels protecting us. So Yaakov Avinu, when he was hearing back from the angel that he sends 400 angels, that Esav has 400 warriors coming towards him, Yaakov Avinu was getting even worse fearful from Esav, as the Torah says, Vayar Yaakov meod vayitzar lo vayechatz et ha'am asher ito ve'et ha'tzon ve'et ha'bakar ve'et ha'gamalim lishnei machanot. Yaakov Avinu, out of fear, he divides his camp. But Yaakov Avinu says something amazing. Yaakov Avinu says, okay, you have 400 angels. I have 613 angels, Taryag Mitzvot. And if our angels fight, that means the 400 of yours and the 400 of mine will eliminate each other. And we'll have remaining 213 angels. That means I will beat you still. And he proved to him that it says that what's 613 minus the 400, you have 213. And the Ben Ish Chai says something beautiful. The Ben Ish Chai says that Yaakov Avinu was proving to Esav, I will win. The 213 in Gematria is what we call El Yaakov, that Hashem and his angel will protect me. El Yaakov, Gematria 213. So Esav, all of a sudden, understand that something else is going on, and Yaakov really may be able to protect him. They say here, the Torah says that Yaakov Avinu was so fearful that he divided his camps into two portions. And he says that, from here, by the way, we'll learn how we should always, you know, protect our stuff. Never put all your eggs in one basket, I'm sorry, and put, you know, when it comes to anything in your life, you should divide it so you can protect half of it in case there is a problem. And he says, Vayomer, Im yavo Esav el hamachane achat v'ikau, v'ayah hamachane anishal lifleta. God forbid if something happened, if Esav comes and destroy one of the camps. Yaakov separated the camps of Leah and Rachel in one group and the camps of Zilpah and Leah in the other group. As he had four wives, as we know, this is the acronym of Barzel, hence Kipat Barzel, Bilha Rachel, Zilpah Leah. אנחנו רואים פה שיעקב אבינו says, ויאמר יעקב אלוהי אבי אברהם ואלוהי אבי יצחק, אדוני האומר אליי, שוב לארצך ולמולדתך ואתיב עמך. All of a sudden, יעקב is praying to Hashem. Questions ask, why Yaakov did not pray to Hashem in the beginning? Why did he fear Esav so much? So as we know, Yaakov Avinu, everything that he did was 100% kosher, and everything that he got from the blessing was 100% kosher. But you know, Yaakov was fearful. That's why he says, Vaishlach is an acronym, Yaakov Shalach Le'Esav Chayil. He sends, you know, warriors and angels, meaning that, you know, he first did not really fully engulfed in Hashem as far as the trust, because you know, only secondary comes to Hashem now. He says, Hashem, you promised me that you bring me back home safely and everything. He asks Hashem, and he says, Katonti mikol hachasadim. He says, Katonti means I'm belittling myself because you've done so much for me. Yaakov feared that perhaps Hashem already gave him so much between leaving the home of his father and mother, going through, of course, Eliphaz that tried to kill him and he won, then going through, you know, the 20 years with Lavan, coming back, everything. Yaakov Avinu says, maybe Hashem did already too much for me. Maybe I'm not worthy anymore miracles, so to speak. So we see here that Yaakov Avinu says, Ki b'makli avarti et hayarden. Haze ve'ata hayti lishne machanot. So Yaakov says, b'makli. B'makli is with my staff. Yaakov Avinu says, all I had is my staff with me. But b'makli is also two words, bam and koli. B'makli is bam and koli. Yaakov says, I prayed a kol kol Yaakov. I always prayed to you, Hashem. I learned Torah with a voice. Bam, what's bam? In Gematria is 42. Also, bam is what Yaakov was hinting to, the 42 journeys of the people of Israel in the desert. And the 42 years they'll be in the desert. And he says, Bam, Vedibarta Bam, as we pray every morning in Shachrit, we say Vedibarta Bam, and you know, in Arvit, Vedibarta Bam. Bam is what the two Torahs that we have. Bet is for the written Torah, for Bereshit, Genesis, the five books of Torah. And Mem is the oral Torah, we call the Gemara, right? The Gemara, which starts with Masechet Brachot, says Me'ematai. Me'ematai is again the Mem. So Yaakov Avinu says, with my voice, with the call, with the blessings and the Torah, both the oral and the written Torah, I crossed the river of the Jordan. And now I have two Leshnei Machanot. It says, Mot Hazeh, Zeh in Gematria 12. I'll be having 12 tribes. And Hashem, I want you to save me. And he says, Hatzileni na miyad achi miyad Esav. Yaakov Avinu says, save me, Hashem, from my brother Esav. And we know that Yaakov used the word na. Na in Hebrew means please. But it also is a secret. Yaakov Avinu says to HaKadosh Baruch Hu and to us, to teachers through the Torah, he says that when he says Hatzileni na, Na is actually the four galuyot, the four exiles that we have. The first Nun Aleph, it says it's Bavel Umadai. Na is for Nebuchadnezzar, Nun. Aleph for Ahasuerus. As we know, we have the Galut Bavel after the destruction of the first temple. And then we have the Galut of Madai, which is the Persia, which is Ahasuerus. That's the Na HaRishon. Then the second Na is the Galut of Greece, right? With the Yevanim, Antiochus. It says, Na is Nun for Nicanor, and Aleph for Antiochus. And the third Na, it was the Romans, right? What we call the Romans, Galut Romi. And it's two, Nun Aleph is for Neron and Astisanus. And the fourth Na, which we are now, Na is Natsrut and Islam. So Yaakov Avinu was basically asking Hashem to save us from all this galiot, the future children of Yaakov, which is the people of Israel. And by the way, he says, Atzileni na miyad achi, miyad Esav. He also says, listen, Hashem, please send me for my brother. Esav is his own brother. You know, today we see Chalila, many of our own brothers go against Hashem, go against Israel. You know, Atzileni na miyad achi. Achi is my brother, which is, you know, unfortunately, we have a lot of brothers, you know, that behaving worse than enemies. And we see the catastrophes that happen to us all over the world. A lot of them come because of our own brother that left Hashem. And also, the Zohar says that when Achi, when he said, Hatzilena miyad Achi, Esav had another son named Achi. So he says, save me from the brother, from the son of Esav, but also, we know that Eliphaz, the son of Esau that wanted to kill him and did not succeed, from him will come Amalek. You know, Eliphaz had six children, and he married one of his sister named Timnah. The Torah says it was a Pilegesh. Pilegesh is Yesh Peleg. And from her will come Amalek. Yaakov was basically saying to Hashem, save us from our brother Esau. In the future, Esav will become Germany. As we know in Masechet Chagiga, Yaakov Avinu asked Hashem to not let the people of Esav become Germany because they'll destroy the world. this is, remember, almost 3,000 years. We see here that the Torah, and then Hashem says, ואתה אמרת, היטב היטיב עמך ושמתיך, ושמתי את זרעך ככל הים, אשר לא יספר מרוב, ואילן שם בלילה ההוא, ויקח מן הבא בידו, מנחה לעשיו אחיו. So he says here is that Yaakov Avinu Vayilen is not really sleeping, he was complaining, tluna. Yaakov was complaining all night, and then he takes 550 cattle. It's very interesting, you know, Yaakov Avinu, he says, how am I gonna, you know, win my brother Esav? How do the good win the evil? You know, evil is all about material items. Evil usually wants to destroy. The people of Israel that were always wanted to be destroyed by the enemies said, let's do two things. Let's destroy their mind and let's destroy their body. Right? Amalek, you know, people of Esav, which is Edom, which is, you know, Christianity, throughout history, they wanted the people of Israel just to become Christian, to change their minds and behavior and be like them, materialistic. And of course, the Islam wanted to destroy the physical, you know, Pere Adam, it says Ishmaelis. So Hashem gave Yaakov the wisdom to how he can win his enemies, how good can, you know, win and defeat evil. You know, but the word evil, if you rearrange the letters, the word live, right? It exists all the time. And we have to fight it every day. And Yaakov Avinu, he takes certain cattle and he places it in a certain order and a certain quantity and a certain distance. So the Torah says that Yaakov Avinu, he took kevasim. Kevasim is what we call the goats, the sheep, right? And then he takes the camels. Then he takes, the camels. Then he takes the goats, the ezim. Then he takes the horses. And at the end, he put the donkeys. Questions ask, why Yaakov Avinu doing this kind of arrangement? By the way, Yaakov Avinu altogether put 550 of them. So Yaakov Avinu placed them, those kind of, you know, cattle in the order of their pregnancy. For an example, it says that the sheeps, he put them first, they are pregnant for 5 months. Then the camels, he put them second, they are pregnant for 6 months. Then he put the goats third, and they are pregnant for 9 months. Then he put the horses, which pregnant for 12 months. And then at the end, he puts the donkey. The donkey resembles Mashiach ben David. The 550, Yaakov Avinu says, look, even though I live with Lavan and I have all this amazing amassed, you know, I'm going to give you a ma'aser, I'm going to give you a tenth of everything I have. And it says to him, it comes to 550. The 550 in Gematria, El HaSelichot. Yaakov Avinu says, I want you to receive this as Selichot, as a forgiveness from, you know, not being and not doing, you know, first and foremost, kibud avahem, kabed et avicha ve'et imecha. It says, you respect your parents. Yaakov missed from respecting his parents for 22 years. That's why, by the way, Yosef will be missing from his life for 22 years. And then Yaakov sends these cattle, and he put a distance between them. They say that the distance was 24 hours. Yaakov Avinu was separating those kind of groups by 24 hours. And he says, "V'yitzav harishon le'emor, kivgeshcha Esav achi v'shalcha le'emor, le'mi ata ve'ana telech ve'le'mi ele lefanecha." Yaakov instructs the first leader of the group of what we said, the sheep as we know. And he says, if you come upon Esav and says, "La'avdecha le'yaakov minchahi." Yaakov, tell him that this is your, from your servant Yaakov. By the way, Hashem was very, very upset with Yaakov that he keeps saying servant, as we know, 7 times. And he says, Adoni, and he says, V'hine gam hu acharenu. So Yaakov basically placed out all these 5 groups of cattle, and Esav sees one. He was so like, what is going on here? And the leader of that first stair says, this is for you, from Yaakov, your brother. Then you see the second, and again, the second, and you know, this is how you win evil. You give the material stuff, right? Many people that, you know, we see today a lot of evil that come and try to take things from you. You know, you have the mafia and you have all these other things that come and says, if you don't give me, I'll kill you, I'll destroy you, I'll do this, I'll do that. When you give them stuff, that's it. You know, they're happy, as if like this is what they're going to take with them to the world to come. So Yaakov Avinu knew how to deal with this evil. And he said, let me give him gifts. As we said, Hashochat Ya'aver, and then Tzaddikim, you know, he says, and the Pikhim, he says that the Shochat, the bribes, can blind even the most righteous people. What does it mean? You know, Shochat means bribe. But if you arrange the letters, Shochat is Hashud. You become a suspect. When you receive bribe, you automatically become part of the problem. You become a suspect. Ever, you become Iver. Iver is from the word Or, right? Your skin then changes. That's what happened, by the way, with Adam and Chava, when Hashem changed their Or from Or. Originally, they were made out of light, Or, Aleph, and they changed it to Or. Or with Ein is the word Iver, blind. When we do sins, we get blinded by the Shochad. You know, most sins, as we know, last a very, very few minutes or seconds sometimes. You know, you just do a sin and it's over. You take whatever. If you steal something, it takes a minute or a second or whatever. You know, if you do a sin on Shabbat, sometimes you can just, you know, light a, you know, a light in the house or whatever, chas v'chalila, if you do it. The sin lasts very, very short amount of time. But the sin will stay with you forever. You always remember it and you always know that you have to pay for it. So it's a very important to really, Ezehu Gibor HaKoveshet Yitzro, who is the one that's the truly the hero, is the one that can control himself or herself and not do sins. So Yaakov Avinu, he sends all these gifts to Esav. And Yaakov Avinu says, this is a mincha, this is my selichot. Ela selichot, 550, the amount that he sends over. And he says, V'hu lan balayla ha'u b'machane, v'yakom. As we say, v'lan, you know, v'yalen, he was complaining. He was really, really kind of complaining to Hashem. But Hashem says, I will also already protect you. What are you worried about? Balayla ha'u, Yaakov Avinu says, v'yakom. He rose, stood up, and v'yikach et shtei נשב ואת שתי שפחותיו ואחד עשר ילדיו ויעבור את מעבר יבוק. יעקב אבינו takes all his wives and children, but here the Torah says that he had 11, but in reality he had 12. He had 11 boys and one girl, Dina. So the Gemara will teach us that Yaakov Avinu hid Dina in a trunk and locked her up, because he did not want Esav to chas v'chalila take her and do what he does with the other, that he always take women and rape them. And Yaakov feared for his daughter Dina. But you know, in Masechet Sota, if I'm not mistaken, oh no, Masechet Nida, it says that HaKadosh Baruch Hu was also upset with him for doing that, because he said that Dina could have changed Esav and make him righteous. As we know, many times in the past, we have women that take wicked people and make them righteous. Rabbi Akiva, for an example. Rabbi Akiva was 40 years old. And when Rachel, the daughter of Kalba Savua, by the way, Kalba Savua was not his real name. Kalba Savua was actually a very righteous and very rich man in Yerushalayim that owned a lot of the land of Israel. And his daughter, Rachel, saw something in Rabbi Akiva. Rabbi Akiva used to work for her father before. You know, he was not, you know, he was the worker that used to change the hoofs, you know, and the metal hoofs that he put on the horses. He used to do that. And Rachel was able to change him 180 degrees to become the most righteous person. And also we know that even it happens with Resh Lakish. Resh Lakish was the head of the gangs of Israel. And the sister of Yohanan was able to change him, and he became the biggest tzaddik, Chavrutat Rabbi Yohanan. So Hashem was upset that Yaakov hid Dina. He says she could have changed Esav completely. The Torah says here that he took them over a Nachal, Ma'avar Yabok. He took them, you know, into a Nachal that's named Yabok. Some say Yabok is the Jordan River. Ve'ikachem ve'avirem et ha'nachal ve'aver et kol asher lo. You know, he took all that he had and he put across the river. And all of a sudden, Yaakov, all of a sudden, has to go back, cross over the Nachal Yabok, because he forgot something. The Gemara will tell us that Yaakov Avinu forgot Pachim Ketanim. Pachim Ketanim, he forgot the oil that he wanted to ensure the, what we call the miracle of Hanukkah, Nes Pach HaShemen, this small jar of oil that Yaakov Avinu forgot, he went back to bring. They said that tzaddikim are very, very careful with their money because they don't really make a lot of money. They study Torah all the time. And when they have something, they're very, very, very careful about, you know, not to lose it. It says that Yaakov Avinu went back. Vayvater Yaakov levado, vayavek ishimo ad alot ha-shachar. So Yaakov Avinu goes back and he fights. We know the Zohar said that Esav sends his angel Samael. Samael is what we call Satan. Samael is also the word Islam, right? Same letters. Yaakov Avinu fights with this angel his whole night. They say Vayavekimo. They say that the dust from the earth reached all the way to the throne of Hashem, all the way to the seat of Hashem. Hashem doesn't really have a seat. We know this is just for us to understand. And it says that Yaakov Avinu was fighting this angel all night. And throughout the fight, Yaakov Avinu was the only one. You know, Yaakov Avinu is the only one that was able to defeat Satan and Malach HaMavet. And his wife, L-I-T, right? Lamed Yud, Lamed Yutaf. L-I-L-I-T. And so you're not allowed to say her name, by the way. It says that Yaakov Avinu fought with him the whole night and won. Yaakov Avinu was the only one to ever defeat an angel. Any person in the world that was able to defeat an angel was only Yaakov. Vayavek ishimo ad alot ha-shachar. So Yaakov Avinu defeat this, and all of a sudden, you know, this angel sees that he cannot win Yaakov, so he hit him. This angel all of a sudden hurt Yaakov in the sciatic nerve. Question is asked, why this angel, you know, if he wanted to hurt Yaakov, he could just hit it in his eyes, make him blind, right? Or, you know, God forbid, hit him in his heart. Why? On his stomach or something horrific that could really destroy Yaakov. But this angel does something. He hits him on the left side in the back. It's called the sciatic nerve. Gid Hanashe. So before we get to the answer, it's important that we should go back to the book of Bereshit. You know, when Adam and Chava sinned with the eating from the tree of knowledge, as we know, HaKadosh Baruch Hu punished Adam with 10 punishments, curses, and with Chava with 10 curses, and the snake with 10 curses, and the land with 9 curses, 39 curses altogether. But when the sin happened, with the sin, when Hashem came to Adam HaRishon, he says, Ayeka, what have you done? Where are you? Vayikra Adonai Elohim El Adam vayomer lo ayeka. You know what's ayeka? Ayeka means, where are you? Where are you holding? What have you done? But also ayeka is four words. It's an acronym of Elohim Yodea Kol Anistarot. What are you hiding? I know all the secrets. I see everything. You cannot hide from me. And Adam says, of course, he blames first Hashem. He says, it's the woman you gave me. What do you want from me? You gave me this woman, and she gave me to eat from that. And Hashem goes to Chava, and he says to her, what have you done? V'tomer Aisha, hanachash, hishi'ani. Chava basically hinting to us about Hishiani, this is the Gid Hanashe. She said that, you know, in the future, from myself and from Adam, as we know, the only neshama that came to the world until today was only one neshama. In Adam and Eve, there were one neshama. And after Hashem reduced them, the sparks that came from this neshama is all the people in the world. Is every one of us has the neshama, is a spark of Adam and Eve. We're not really our full neshama. Full neshama is a neshama that could be something that never we've seen before, only was exist in Adam before the sin. As it says, Zacharu nekeva bara otam, vayikra lahem Adam. They were one, and Hashem called it Adam. And that was the first neshama and only neshama that came to the world. And it was such a neshama that soon, originally we're not supposed to die or anything. There's no limits to this neshama. Only after the sin come death to the world of, you know, with Adam, well, originally was 1,000 years. And of course, you know, he gives 7 years to David HaMelech. But here the Chava says, Ki hanachash hishiani. Hishiani, she alludes to this Gid Hanashe. You know, why Satan was fighting Yaakov, and at the end, he was trying to take something away from him. And he hit him at the sciatic nerve. So the Zohar says something amazing. It says that Yaakov Avinu, when Esav sold the Bechorah to Yaakov, and Yaakov purchased the Bechorah, they had an agreement. Yaakov had a certificate, a document that they both signed. It was made out of papyrus, and Yaakov had Esav sign for it. When they Shavah Ali, when Yaakov says, swear by it, you have to sign by it. And they signed it, and Yaakov took this certificate. And Zohar says that Yaakov Avinu was afraid that Esav will find it in his home and destroy it, and there will never be the Mechirat Bechorah, which is to be Bechorah Amim, to be the people that keep the Torah. And also Bechorah, Yaakov purchased the right to marry Leah, she was the Bechorah. And Yaakov sewed this agreement into his body, and he put it exactly in the sciatic nerve on the left above the hip. That's where Yaakov hid and made a small incision and put it in and then sewed it. And that's where the angel of Esav was trying to grab this, to take it out of his body. When he finally could not, and he see that he cannot defeat Yaakov, he hit him so hard that Yaakov started being what we call Tzolea. Yaakov could not walk right. So it says, as we know, the Nahash, Hashem cursed. You know, what did Hashem curse? He says, Ve'eva ashid bencha uven aisha, uven zaracha, uven zara'a, hu yeshufcha rosh, ve'ata toshifenu akev. So the Zohar says something amazing. He says that from day one, you know, from the beginning, because of the sin of the snake, Hashem cursed mankind and the snake with, what do we say? HaKadosh Baruch Hu cursed them. He says to the snake, he says, Hu yeshuvcha rosh ve'ata toshivenu akev. The snake will have to, you, in order to destroy the snake, you have to hit him in the head. And the snake has to bite you in your akev. So Yaakov is akev, right? And what Rosh is Israel. What's Israel? El Rosh, right? The head of the world is Hashem. And we are Yeshar El. We have to be straight with Hashem. So it says here that Yaakov Avinu, the angel hit him in the sciatic nerve. We see here something amazing. You know, the Zohar says that Yetzer Hara, which is part of the snake, which is part of Satan, which is part, has seven names to Satan. It resides in our body in the sciatic nerve. That's where it resides. That's why the angel of Yaakov, of Esav, fought Yaakov all night, hit him at the sciatic nerve to try to take this agreement that they had on the purchase of the Bechorah. And he failed. And Yaakov Avinu was the only one to defeat. And Yaakov Avinu defeated the angel. Yaakov Avinu says, Yaakov Avinu says that because I defeat you, the angel says to him, let me go. The morning had come. Allah HaShachar. Allah HaShachar. Allah HaShachar. The morning has come and I have to go sing to Hashem. I have to go and praise Hashem, the angel says to Yaakov. And Yaakov says, you cannot go until, the Torah says, you cannot go. The Torah, ויאמר לו, לא אשלחך כי אם ברכתני. Yaakov says, you know, ברכתני is in the past. Like, bless me from before. What does it mean? So Yaakov says to him, I want you to guarantee to me that the blessing I got from my father Yitzchak, I want you to validate him, because I did it right. Esav did not want to be the Bechor. He did not want to keep Torah. I purchased it. I paid him. We had an agreement. I signed everything. He signed everything. So the angel says, Vayomar Elav, Mashimcha. The angel says, what's your name? As if he doesn't know Yaakov. He was sent to fight him all night. What do you mean, what's your name? What the angel was saying to Yaakov, he says, ויאמר הגיד אנא שמך, יעקב, he says to him, the angel says, I'm not going to call you Yaakov from now on. He revealed to him that Hashem will change your name to Israel. And all the blessing will come on your children too, the people of Israel. As we said, what's Israel? Israel is the only name that has all the four mothers and fathers, right? Yud, Yitzchak and Yaakov, Shin for Sarah, Resh, Rivka and Rachel, Aleph Avraham, Lamed Leah. It's Israel. So the angel revealed to him that your name will be changed, as we know later on it will be. And he says, Ki sarita im Elohim ve'im anashim ve'tuchal. He says, you are the only one that stays with Hashem. And the only one that defeat angel. And your people of Israel will be able to do it in the future. Ki malacha ve'tzavelcha lishmurcha. You have angel that can protect you from other angels. וישאל יעקב ואמר לו הגיד אנא שמך. He says, what's your name? The angel says, why are you asking for my name? יעקב basically says to him, I want to know that, you know, your mission is done, because angels are sent only for one mission, except Satan. Satan has many missions, right? But for an example, Michael, he comes, מי כמוך אל, he comes to show the greatness of Hashem. Rafael, רפואה, comes to heal. Gabriel, גבורה, right? And the angel says, this angel says, don't, I don't want to tell you my name so you don't shame me in the worlds, because then everybody knows that you defeat me. Let me go back. And Yaakov says, Vayikra Yaakov shemakom Pene El. Pene El is the face of Hashem. He says, I was able to see even the angel of Hashem. You know, Satan is also an angel. Good or bad, he's an angel. That Hashem made him like that is a different story. But he's an angel. Says, I saw the angel of Hashem, Penei El, this is the face of Hashem. Ki ra'iti Elohim panim el panim, v'tinatzel nafshi. So this is a little problem here, because you know, they said the only person in the Jewish people that Hashem was face to face was Moshe Rabbeinu. And you know, for the Goyim was Bil'am. He says, what do you mean panim el panim? What do you mean face to face? He says, I saw evil face to face, and I was able to defeat evil. They say, how do we defeat evil? There's always war between good and bad, right? Tov v'ra, right? How do we defeat evil? With the Tov. The Tov is Torah. Only with Torah you can defeat evil. That's why Yaakov says, Im Lavan garti, v'tariyag mitzvot shamarti. I live with Lavan, but I kept all 613 mitzvot. How can you keep 613 mitzvot? We know that when Yaakov was in the house of Lavan, there was no Bet HaMikdash. There was no Shemitah, no Kohanim, Levim. How can you keep all 613 mitzvot? It's impossible. What does it mean? Yaakov used the term Veneshalma Parim Sfateinu. So when we learn about anything, it's just that we've done it. For an example, when you do sacrifice, we don't have sacrifice today. ונשלמה פרים שפתנו, when we learn about the sacrifice, when we read the korbanot, as if like we've done them. So Yaakov learned about all the mitzvot, and he was able to keep all of them, even though he did not really have to do it physically. But when you study about them, it's considered as you do it, and learn it, and you entitled to all of it. So he says, and because of that, על כן לא יוכלו בני ישראל את גיד הנשה אשר על כף הירך. You know, הנשה, as we said, comes from the Bereshit. When the Chava says, כי הנחש השיעני, the snake, in the future, Satan will hurt Yaakov in the גיד הנשה, on the left. You know, they're all, book of Bereshit, there's only three mitzvot. That's it. The first one is Pru Urvu, married and children. The second one is Brit Milah, Bezat Hashem, and the third one is the Sa'arik Nav, the whole book of Bereshit, only three mitzvot. That's it. So it says here that Yaakov, you know, he hit him so hard that he could not walk right. Right? He was very much kind of, you know, almost like, what do you call when he stumbled?
Disabled?
No, but it was like walking, but with a... Not a good walk.
A limp.
Yeah, that he was limping. Thank you. You know, the Zohar says something amazing. It says that the angel did see that he could not destroy Yaakov, so he says, "Let me hit his body, where the legs are really carries the body, right?" And the Gid HaNasheh, which is the Yerech, which is, you know, what we call the hip, he hit him there. Why? He said one day. They said that, how can I destroy Torah? Satan says, how? How can I help destroy Torah? He says that, you know, the Bnei Torah, they learn all day. But the people that support them, I want to hurt them. Tomchei Torah. That's why he says that one day there'll be yeshivot, there'll be people of Torah. They cannot work, but there'll be rich people supporting them. We learn them from... You know, Zevulun and Issachar, right? Mm-hmm. Issachar was the Torah, Zevulun was supplying with everything. But they're 50-50 on the mitzvot. Mm-hmm. So Satan says, let me hurt the people that support them in the future. Because the body is carried by the legs. Right? That's why he says that Hakol Kol Yaakov, when we pray with the voice of Yaakov, the blessing of Hashem, then Hayadaim, the hands that support us will be the hands of Esav that Esav destroyed. So in the future, we have many people that support yeshivot. All of a sudden, they have bad business. So they cannot support the yeshivot. That's what Satan was going after in the fight with Yaakov. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it's very interesting. There is once a rabbi in Yerushalayim that I know. I won't say his name. But he had a deal with this very rich guy in Yerushalayim, had factories there. And he says, I'll support your yeshiva. But promise me that you always bless me every day. Well, before you study, say the bracha of so-and-so and this and this. 1 month, this big gvir, this rich guy, comes to the rabbi and says, something is wrong. He did not study well this month. He says, why? He says, I lost half of my business this month. So the rabbi started investigating. He figured out that the students were really not studying well. And he said to them, you know, only because of our studies we are able to have this rich guy support us. So please, from now on, don't slack off. Study well. And that's exactly what happened. They studied so well, and they became rich again. That's Issachar and Zevulun. The word Issachar is Yesh Sachar. There is reward. Why? It has Tushin, right? Shai and Shai. Shin is reward. Which we call Shishi, Shabbat, these two rewards. When Issachar study well, Zevulun makes a lot of money to support both of them. Zevulun, and imagine, there's a whole tribe, it's not just one person. Thousands, hundreds of thousands of people. Times two. Zevulun and Issachar. So we see here that Yaakov Avinu, now after this whole episode with the angel and he wins, and then he divides his camp to four, you know, and he says, that of course you know that Yaakov Avinu, angel says there's 400 of Esav's soldiers coming to kill you. Yaakov was fearful, says, why? Why are they coming to kill me? That means Yitzchak died. My father died, and he was very, very upset. Because Esav promised, I'll only kill you when my father is dead. But he noticed something else. He noticed that Esav sent somebody, not him. So the Zohar said that Esav actually said, let them kill him so they don't say it's me, and I won't do chaz v'chalil achet against my father. But it says that, the Zohar says that Lavan said to Esav, he sends messengers, says, listen, you have to kill Yaakov, he stole everything I have. Whatever you kill him, it's yours. All the wealth that Yaakov has, gold and silver and all the cattle and everything, all his children will be yours, everything will be yours. And then he sent a message to Rivka, his mother, which is his sister, Lavan. He says to her, you know, Esav is killing already Yaakov. All happened in the same time. Okay? And then Yaakov Avinu divide, and he put first, he put what we call the four mothers, right? He put the Shfachot first, Zilpah and her two kids, Bilhah and her two kids, Leah and her six kids. He hides Dinah. The Torah says 11, not 12. Then he puts Rachel and Yosef. So Yaakov goes in the front. He's the first one to face Esav. This is the leadership of Israel. You know, we're the only military that the heads of military goes in front. All other military, they send their soldiers first. We learn that from Yaakov. Yaakov comes and he says, Vayishtachu arza sheva pe'amim. Yaakov bows seven times. Now, as we know, we have two thoughts. One, the Gemara says that because Yaakov Avinu bows seven times, there will be seven disasters coming to Israel. There will be the wars, right? There will be what we call the three world war. There will be the two destruction of the Mikdash. And there will be what we call the, you know, by the way, the Holocaust is part of the Second World War. And there will be the wars of, you know, like we know, the Christians, Inquisition, and the Islam, you know. Seven disasters came to the children of Israel because Yaakov bowed seven times. But I read something amazing yesterday on Shabbat. Not yesterday, 2 days ago on Shabbat. There's a book called Me Marom. Me Marom is written by two rabbis in Jerusalem. One of them passed away, Zichrono Levracha, Rabbi Leib. And it says something amazing. What Yaakov was bowing to Esav is seven times. First, it says seven pa'amim ipol tzadik vakam. Sheva pa'amim ipol tzadik vakam. There's seven times tzadik can fall and rise. Even though no matter how big you are, you can always fall. The biggest tzadikim can fall. So we know that Yaakov gives us the ability to always rise. Right? And also what Yaakov was bind to Esav, I want to thank you for the seven most righteous people that come from you in the future. You know, there is what we call converts. Gerei Tzedek. And Yaakov was thanking Esav for who are the seven Gerei Tzedek, seven converts that came from Christianity, from Edom. He says, Shmaya ve'Avtalion. You know, they were the teacher of Hillel and Shammai. Two converts that came, they were none other from the grandkids of Sancheriv. Sancheriv, by the way, also converted. He was the king of the world that mixed all the world. From him will come two tzaddikim, converts, that will teach the entire Gemara almost. And then will be Rabbi Meir Baal HaNes. Rabbi Meir Baal HaNes, as we know, he was the family from the children of Neron. Neron, the Caesar, you know, of Rome. And there will be Rabbi Akiva, will come from Cicero. Then the fifth one, will be Shmuel Bar Shilat, will come from Haman, which is Agagi, Amaliki. And Unkelus also, it will come from the kings of Rome, you know, Edomites. And Ovadia Navi, Ovadia the prophet, came also from Edomites, And he's the one that says the famous verse, which is amazing. It says, "V'haya bet Yaakov esh, uvet Yosef le'ava, uvet Esav le'kash." Said that the children of Yaakov and Yosef will be fire, and they'll burn the hay of Esav. Meaning the Bet HaMikdash will come, the third one will defeat. So Yaakov Avinu, the Torah says here that, you know, when he bowed seven times, he was thanking. Both first for the seven things for the people of Israel to survive, and for the seven tzaddikim that will come from Edom. And the Torah says, Vayeshakehu, Vayefku, it says that they kissed each other and cried. But the word Vayeshakehu has six dots above it. They said that six times Esav was trying to bite his neck and kill him. But the neck of Yaakov became what we call Shaish. Yeah. Shaish in Hebrew is ceramic, like a very strong marble. Like his teeth broke of Esav. Six times he tried to bite him. And all of a sudden, Vayisait Enav, Vayar says, what is all these people here? The women and the children and everything. So everybody came. Yaakov says, Vayomer Hailadim Asher Chanan Elohim. Hashem gave me those. It's not really, I didn't get any of the blessing that your father, our father says, you won, you know, look, you are the king, I was a slave in Laban's house, and you, on the other hand, became a king, you have all the wealth, everybody's afraid of you, I have nothing, everything that I gave you all the stuff, by the way, he gave you 550 items, right, cattle, 550 is El HaSelichot, he says, I'm making slichot with you, Bimatria, this is my ma'aser for you. They said that anything that you do in the Gola has no blessing, as far as, you know, Maaser for Israel. So they gave it to him. But all of them was Mem. At the end, it was not kosher. Yaakov was ability to just touch a goat and say if it's kosher or not. Not kosher, give it to Esav. So it says here that after everybody came and bowed, but when it comes to, you know, it says that, you know, the mothers can bow than the children. But when it comes to Rachel, Yosef came in front of her, and the Zohar said that Yosef became so big that Esav could not see Rachel. She was gorgeous. He didn't want to take her. Because Esav said, well, you took my wife, Leah, I'll take your wife, Rachel. But Yosef, Alesho, he became big. Like an ox, strong. And he covered, Ale Ain, he covered the eye of Esav. That's why Yosef has no Enara. Enara doesn't control him. That's why he was able to not do anything with Potiphar's wife in the future. So it says here, after that, they are making peace and Esav goes Seira, right? He goes to what we call Seir and Edom, which is Seir la'azazel, right? We do a korban of Seir to Esav, to Yetzer Hara, and to Edom. As we know, that Yaakov nasa Sukkotah. Vayven lo, bait lemikneu. Yaakov is the first one to do the pound for animals. We are the only Torah that cares for animals. Yaakov built homes for the animal called Sukkot. He built them huts. That's the first Sukkot in the Torah. You know? It says here, Asa Sukkot, al ken karashem amakom Sukkot. And then he stays there for 18 months. You know, Yaakov, when he meets Esav, he's 97 years old. After 20 years with Lavan, right? And he says that after 18 months in Sukkot, he goes, Yaakov, Shalem, Ir Shechem. He goes then full, like everything's Shalom, right? Peace comes from the word Shalem. It's a whole, it's full, filled with everything. When you have peace, that means everything is good. You can have all the money in the world, but if you don't have peace, what's the money worth? You always worry, always have everything problem. It says, Vayavo Yaakov, Shalem, Ir Shechem. אשר בארץ כנעה בבוא פדן הרב, היחן את פני העיר. So he says, יעקב purchased, ויקן את חלקת השדה. By the way, יעקב purchased the portion of Shechem, because in the future, Yosef will be buried. We know three portions were purchased by money. Abraham, as we know, bought Me'arat HaMachpelah in the field. יעקב bought Shechem, and David HaMelech bought Yerushalayim. For the temple. So he says that he then stayed there, and all of a sudden the Torah says, Vatetze Dina bat Leah, Asher yalda le'Yaakov lirot bevnot haaretz. So Dina goes out, show off, so to speak, חס וחלילה. I said, like her mother. Because her mother says, ותצא לאה לקראת יעקב. She purchased the night to be with him. Remember, she gave the דודאים to רחל. And says, it's my night, come with me. As if like, what is the chutzpah, חס וחלילה.
What's the דודאים?
דודאים, those are the fruit that women can get pregnant by.
Yeah.
It's a special fruit, דודאים, that Reuven found. So it says here, by the way, etrog has the same power.
Hmm.
Yes, it's etrog. If women can have children, you actually make a jam out of it, and you give it to a pregnant woman, it's hatzlacha, segula be'ezrat Hashem. We did it, I know it works, twice. We got some etrogim from Rabbi Chaim Kanievsky, and yes, we made, and my wife made, she gave our neighbor, could not have a child for 5 years, She gave it, now she has 3 kids.
Wow. Shiduch?
Huh? Jewish woman. Very nice.
And all Hashem. Named Eshrog.
So it says here that Dina came out, show off, you know, they said that something amazing happened. Dina all of a sudden is get kidnapped by Shechem ben Hamor.
Mm-hmm.
The prince of the king of Shechem, Hamor is his name. He takes and he rapes her and he tortures her.
Mm. First and foremost, he loved her.
Yeah, he loved her after he raped her. But they said that, you know, a woman of the people of Israel should never come out to the goyim.
That's right.
Always be humble, stay with her father and mother, her brothers, never walk out, you know, alone. By the way, the Arabs learned that from here. The Arabs don't allow their wives to come out alone. You have to have escort. Right?
Yeah.
If you're in Iran, if a woman goes out by herself, they kill her. Yeah. So you see here, we have a few minutes and we'll finish. So you know, they say that the Chas v'Chalila, what happened to Dina, where did it come from? So we know that the people of Shechem, you know, the son, the prince, sent his father to say, I love, tell Yaakov, I love, let's get married together, let's mix up people.
Mm-hmm.
Let's, you know, you take our daughters, we take your boys, we'll marry each other and this. Hamor comes to Yaakov and says that, and then the children of Yaakov hear what happened. They got so, so upset. But they were smart. They did not show their anger. They said to the people of Shechem, tell you what, you want to be with us? You have to do Brit Milah. You know, we cannot marry people that don't have Brit Milah. We cannot undo the Brit Milah. You can do Brit Milah. Right? You can be circumcised. So why don't you circumcise all the men, and after that, we'll mix up. Then we'll be, you know, together. So they accept that, you know, when people in love are crazy, they do stupid things. Right? The Arab, he was so in love with her that he fell for it. Right? They come to the people of Shechem, says, we all have to do it. So all of them, all the men, from young men all the way to the eldest, did Brit Milah. Come, the Torah says, ובני יעקב באו השדה, right? They were very, very, and they saw נבלה עשה בישראל. This is like a horrific things to do to the daughter of Israel. Especially לבת יעקב. So very righteous. How could it happen to him? So it says here that the two brothers, and the third day of the healing of the Brit Milah is the worst day. That's when Hashem came to Abraham on the third day. To do Bikur Cholim. And then they said, Davaikhu Shene Bene Yaakov, Shimon Velevi. Each one, by the Zohar says, they were, didn't have know of each other. It's just, both of them took their sword and went and killed 24,000 Arabs. Those 24,000 Neshamot is the same Neshamot from Pinchas and Rabbi Akiva.
Uh-huh.
It's a Gilgul. Now, why Dina? Dina was a reincarnation of mothers of Avraham Avinu. Her name was Amtalia Bat Karnavu. She had Avraham when she was in Nida. The word Nida is Dina, is actually in order to take out the bad part of her. You know, Shechem is the Klipa. Dina was raped by Shechem, and from her he will take the bad out of her, and it will remain the goodness of Osnat. Osnat was born. And Osnat will marry Yosef. But Dina, the Torah says here,
I thought it was Potiphar's daughter.
That's Osnat, was adopted by. This is actually the daughter of Dina. Yaakov gave her to Egypt to be saved. and he gave her a perek tehillim to put. And when Yosef saw that, he knew that she's Jewish. That's why he married her. Potiphar's wife adopted her. Okay? Very good question. So it says that they are basically killed the 24,000. And from, as we say, Osnat and Dinah, right? Osnat, the daughter of Dinah, will marry Yosef, and the blessing of the children with her, right? Ephraim and Menashe. That's her children. So it says, the Torah says that Yaakov Avinu, as we said, if you remember, something happened. When Yaakov left after the last parasha of Vayetze, he said, Aser Asrenu Lach, right? I will have 20%, I'll give 1/10 and 1/10. When Yaakov came back after 36 years, he forgot the Maaser, and he made a neder. Neder is a vow. You're not allowed, Chaz v'chalila, not to make your vow. And he forgot. The 10% that he forgot, Aser, Dinah raped. The other Maaser, Rachel dies. But not before she gives him a son named Binyamin. Originally, Rachel gave the son named Ben Oni. It's basically the son of my death. Because, you know, the Zohar says that angel came to her, it's either you or your son, one of you have to die. And she gave her son, her life to her son, Benoni, but Yaakov will change it to Binyamin. Binyamin was the only son that was born in Israel. And was the only son that, Tzabari as we say, that born to Yaakov after his name changed to Israel. And the Torah says that Rachel died in Kiryat Arba. You know, Kiryat Arba is what we say where Rachel is buried today, right? You see, if you look at old pictures, there were never any Arabs around it. It was an empty field. There is a gentleman, a holy, holy man, an Englishman named Moshe Montefiore. You heard of him?
Sure.
Montefiore was the one that built the whole grave. He put everything, because before it was just on the ground, you know. He built the whole thing around it, and he made sure that it was be also known to the people of Israel, where they can go and visit there. And Moshe Montefiore was blessed, you know. And he built all the neighborhoods outside of the walls of Jerusalem. Shchunat Montefiore, you know, the famous windmill in Jerusalem, that's his too. So here the Torah says, and we'll finish with that.
Did you say it was 36 years he was away, Yaakov?
Yeah.
I thought it was 20...
No, it was 14 years at the yeshiva.
And 6?
And 22.
Oh, I see, that's it.
Yes. 22 plus 14...
36.
Leah. Gematria Leah.
Yeah.
Leah, 36. That's why he married Leah first too.
Yeah.
So it says here that Rivka dies. But it doesn't say that Rivka dies. It said that her meyaneket, that her servant, Devorah, died. Devorah came to Yaakov the time, your mother is about to die, come. But Yaakov missed it.
How come?
It was the distance. He was far from her. She was in, you know, they say she died at night, they buried her at night without any big deal. Why? Because she died with Esav and her husband was blind. So they buried her in Me'arat HaMachpelah quietly, so nobody knows, so Chaz v'Chalila no bichilul Hashem.
Wait, who are you talking about now?
Rivka.
Rivka
died. It says, the Torah says, it doesn't say that Rivka died, it says that Devorah Me'aneket Rivka died.
Yeah.
And of course we know that Yaakov will spend now 21 years with his father, Yitzchak. And Yitzchak will pass when he's 180. And it says that Yaakov and Esav, but the Torah says Esav and Yaakov buries, you know, Yitzchak. And it says, Vehu yamav mea shana ushmonim shana. He was full with everything. Vayikveru oto Esav veYaakov. Esav and Yaakov buries him. Unlike when it comes to with Avraham, right? It says Yitzchak and Ishmael. Here Esav want to be first. Does not recognize the honor of parents in the Torah. And here we see that Ele Toldot Esav. We see all the Alufei Esav, the champions of Esav. But there is one, Esav marries an Ishmaelite, Canaanite, a woman named Aholiab, which is has the word Obama in it. Aholibama. Obama was half Christian, half Muslim. Mm-hmm. This is the secrets of him here in the Torah. So Be'ezat Hashem, I wish all of you
Amen.
A wonderful, wonderful week. And Be'ezat Hashem, tomorrow we have a class at the JCC, 7:30, Partners in Torah. The class is sponsored, and the whole month studies, by the way, this month, Baruch Hashem, we're doing the special classes, as we said before, to Mr. Bernie Baruch. HaKadosh Baruch Hu Yerapeh Oto, Baruch Chai Ben Chaya Miriam, he and his wife Zehava sponsoring the month for Kollel, all the studies that we do for this month, Hashem, for 30 days. Hashem will give him a lot of atzlacha.
Amen.
Amen. Be'ezat Hashem will continue to go from Chayil to Chayil.
Amen.
Be'ezat Hashem, this class will be posted on our website at neshatorah.com. Thank you all for coming here and everybody online. God bless you and have a wonderful week.